Oh, crap. Here we go again. Welcome, folks, to one of the craziest journeys I've taken. We're going to take a look at Emblem Saga, which I'm sure is 100% legit. Well, let's dive in and see how long it takes them to screw this one up, huh? Well, don't worry. They got their name wrong in the title screen. Big oof from me here. So you know what? Let's just throw all sorts of names at the wall and see if this sticks. How about Emblem Heroes? Or maybe Hero Saga? Oh, I have a good one. I know it. Tear Ring Saga. That has a nice ring to it. Okay, enough worrying about names. Let's actually load into this now. Starting off with a Stolen Book 2 trailer. Got it. Good stuff. It's little trendsetters like this that I was just honestly expecting this game to be a complete and note-for-note ripoff of Heroes at this point. And then we load in the tutorial. And let me just say,
woo, girl, everything is different. What is going on?
Fjorm is moving, and I'm losing my mind just seeing this. Someone took phase art and converted it into
live TV.
Everyone is jiggly. Well, usually. On some characters, like Fjorm, it's just subtle. Meanwhile, I'm worried about Surtur here. Are you okay? You're breathing quite heavily. Do you need a drink of water? Even Arvis and Michaelis are a part of this story. Just what?
But don't you worry about the jiggly art when it comes to the tutorial, friends. Let's take a look at the story, in that it makes no sense, and if I were to summarize it in any fashion, it'd probably go like this.
Oh my!
Combat doesn't share that attention, though. Battles just feel clunky and delayed. Repositioning abilities work, but they just kind of blink characters in and out of existence. Azura is here, but her singing is less of a melody and more of a war cry.
Go, Kutopia!
I just don't know how to put what I'm seeing right now into words, honestly. And then you finish the tutorial and wake up with... Well, hello,
handsome.
Wait, is this... Oh my god, it's Elowood. And just in case you're wondering here, all of his art has been replaced except for his sprite. And this just makes me question everything about this game. Why redo one character's art completely? Why Elowood? What is going on? But we don't have much time to focus on any of that because the main menu is now accessible and map screen. Stage selection definitely feels more Fire Emblem-like, but we really don't have much option because it's kind of forcing us to continue on with the story. And wouldn't you guess that the next bunch of maps are all tutorials? What a surprise. Let's just hand it to them, though. They are certainly making usage out of everything they took from Heroes, including those old introduction cutscenes they don't use anymore. You remember those at all? Yeah, well, guess what? Tearing Saga has them here. Eventually, Takumi and Camilla join your party, and we learn about the Color Triangle. Or Color Restraining Orders? I don't even know anymore, but Camilla and Takumi both jiggle just as much as the rest of the cast. However, something seems a little off with Camilla here. They seem to have animated her crown horns, like they are cat ears. Did someone even bother to do research over there at Emblem Saga? Either way, don't give IS any ideas for the next Halloween season, okay? I mean, make no mistakes, Catmilla is definitely a treasure, but I think I'm going to get one of those restraining orders, maybe in green? It was around this time that I realized that none of the maps make sense. They are all original creations, but some of them are all out lies. This map clearly reads Hector. I don't think that's Hector, guys. And then you load into the map, and surprise, surprise, I see no Hector. I don't know what I was expecting. Oh, and don't worry, the icons for characters on maps tend to lie as well. They also have the habit of naming things completely wrong or just random gibberish. Oh, wait. That random generic soldier has a name. Is this the equivalent of a red shirt in Star Trek? Ah, well, he's dead. Guys, look, it's Bartray! Oh, wait, no, never mind, it's just a normal soldier. I mean, you get a lot of him normally. He's basically just the run-of-the-mill soldier now at this point anyways. Good observation, Emblem Heroes. Good observation. After going through the story, we eventually unlock the main menu in all of its, glory? It's an absolute mess. But before we can actually dive too deep into that, we are being rushed into summoning. Which is completely different, guys. It uses coins instead of orbs. It's not the same thing, trust me. As for our free summon, we put in our coins and... And then there's Reinhardt. He is your free 5-star for this ripoff. And he's just as jiggly as the rest of them. And then we have his battle animations, and oh boy, just as glitchy as the rest of them, but somehow, strangely, very hypnotic. When it comes to the probability of summoning in this game, they sure have a lot of alms. Like, a lot. I know he's gotten quite a few in Fae, but in Emblem Saga he has like a billion. In all shapes and sizes, too. I mean, let's just take a look at one and see what it looks like. Somehow, even now, I'm still disappointed. I don't know why I was surprised here, but yet somehow, here we are. Okay, you did surprise me in one thing, at least. You can't actually summon the Asker Trio here, so... kudos? I just wasn't having fun with summoning after this point, so when I found out there was an in-game chat, I decided to try and communicate with anyone. It was then that I found out my name in-game was... Kermie Palmer? How did they know? Well, either way, it was time to start talking into the void in the most rational, simple way, making it clear that I was fun and just the absolute best. And no one responded. Well, I can safely say this game is dead. After this point, I decided it was time to dive even further into the story, unlock everything, and see exactly what all of this game has to offer. So, here are my adventures. Bytray's back, but now he's an arena owner. Well, good for him on that promotion, but my team really just has a mustache-shaped hole, waiting for him to come home. Oh, and arena is just copy and paste. Cool, I'm sure just about as many people play it here as they do in Fae. And then Bruno showed up, but I see that he's not necessarily who he says he is, which honestly, I'd change my name if I were in this game too. He's asked me to come to his tower, but I'm pretty sure this is actually the plot to some sort of Stephen King novel. And much to my horror, I found out it was the training tower. Yep, this is indeed post-cocaine Stephen King. Managed to summon a Myrrh, and I have to say, her battle animations are by far my favorite thing in this game. Donald seems to be having a stroke here, so of course we had to put him out to pasture by a crappy and impossible tutorial. Well, he's in a better place now, I think. I was then introduced to the castle, where I can apparently worship people, which I was confused about, but don't worry, I found the one god that Fae prays to every day. That, of course, is Power Creep. And maybe you noticed while I was leveling up, you may have seen two new stats. Well, don't worry, because one of them makes enemies more likely to attack the target, and the other just doesn't make sense. If there's one thing I really love about gacha games is when you're being rewarded. It's the most rewarding experience I've ever had. Who knew that Persia's weakness was the color green? The river here seems to run at a solid 1 frame per second. But as I continued down the story trek, I realized something terribly, terribly wrong. That's not Arden. What did they do to Arden? What's wrong with his face? It was at this point I decided it was time to solve this mystery. You see, Arden wasn't the only one who got hit by the ugly stick. In fact, a lot of characters in this game actually had their character art altered. And I'm not talking replacement, like Ellawood. I mean, they took Fae art and they altered the hell out of it. First up is Gunter, who in his Fae art comes across as a gritty war veteran. Meanwhile, in Legends Emblem, he's a pink-haired babyface but still somehow scarred unit. It's like someone just poured a bunch of bleach on him. Next up is Dorcas, where originally there was a lot of detail. There is none now. His arm suddenly takes the form of a grotesque tumor, and it looks like his face has been penciled on. Zeffy Boy didn't end up so lucky either, as his art was traced as well, and his face honestly just reminds me of a meme. In fact, hold on 1 second. And hey look, I made a meme. And then there's Rebecca. You know Rebecca, right? With her lifeless eyes that stare and slowly bore into your skull. There's a legend, you know. They claim that if you gaze too long into them, you will see how and when you will die. The eyes of a creature who lives and breathes off your very misery. Oh, wow, no, okay, that's actually kind of an improvement. Not bad. The funny thing is, the reason these characters' art was changed was actually quite silly. And that mostly boils down to Live 2D. All of these characters had unique aspects to their art, and all of these aspects would not work when making those characters move in Live 2D. Let's give some examples. Dorcas and Arden both have shading in their original artwork that would make movement in this game a little bit too awkward to manage. While characters like Gunter and Zeph both have art that has a filter over it, making them look a little bit more rugged or a bit antiquated. And trying to get that working in Live 2D would be a nightmare. So they went ahead and redid all of the art for these characters by tracing them. All of them just to get them ready for live 2D. And that kind of sums up Legends Heroes in a nutshell. If I were to describe it in one word, it'd be dissonance. The whole thing just makes me incredibly sad. Remember this river at all? The one that has blink and you'll miss it animation? Yeah, it's things like this that are hilarious, but meanwhile on the very same map, there are clouds moving in and out of the area. These clouds have a pretty good frame rate, and they also cast dynamic shadows down on the ground below them. That includes units too. And that's the big takeaway from this game. There is clearly signs of talent among what I'm assuming is a development team. If not in the coding, then clearly in the art. And this map clearly represents just how baffling all of this really is. Sure, the faces on the redone characters are silly. But if you look at the level of detail that went into reconstructing some of them, like say, their armor, it shows an eye for detail, and I just can't help but ask why. Why bother putting so much effort into a game that is, by design, made to leech off the existence of another for a cheap buck? And that, in some way, kind of breaks my heart. If any of the devs happen to be listening to this at all, consider maybe, just maybe, that you have talent and can see it to fruition elsewhere and not on this crap here. And that's about it when it comes to Emblem Saga. Honestly, I was expecting a direct attempt at ripping off Fire Emblem, and found myself questioning pretty much everything. It's gone now from Google Play, by the way, so there's really no course of action to take. But I thought it'd be fun and silly to look into something that attempted to be Fire Emblem Heroes. Oh hey, look, it's lon'qu. Ah, fuck you, game. Hey, thanks for watching. I wanted to make sure this video was as inconsistent quality-wise as the game was. Yeah, that's the excuse. Be sure to check out the resources below as well as my editor for this video. Sadly, this will probably be the ending for the Ripoff series, but I figured I'd give it a proper send-off. If you liked it, feel free to leave a like, maybe subscribe, as I really want to do more content like this. Anywho's, catch you later.